Say they made that stuff illegal. How would you get through the day?
Oh, I don't know. I'd have to go on to our drugs, I suppose. Looking for a brew?
Am I ever?
Boning up, are we?
Oh, it's just background.
This boy's dead. Hit a wall with his Capri. Car stopped, he didn't. No seat, no seat. This boy's locked up. This boy got married last year. Hasn't put a foot wrong since. Don't think he dares. This lad, I know his brother. Says he's keeping his nose clean. That's family for you.
Thank you very much.
You pull this one. Everybody's had a go at this one. We know who did it, but he's a clever bugger. Just you wait. We'll hang something on him one of these days.
Paul, never speak like that in front of me again.
Hey, Sarge. You do know that they're ripping that jacket.
Morning.
Trouble sleeping?
It's been a month now. I still can't get used to the quiet.
There's some of them can. You're doing it at the Maidman's barn now, aren't you?
Oh, word travels fast, eh?
I know Bill Maidman. He's a bloody good bloke.
You're telling me? You should see what he threw in on the deal.
Oh, not Judy, eh?
Get away. Only the biggest bloody bed you've ever seen. Took four men and a tractor to get it over from the house. I don't think he shipped it with dynamite. Well, anything on there for me?
Find the sign of a couple of runaway boys.
Oh, big time stuff, eh?
Don't knock it. It's still better than working.
Well, it's every man home near Salford.
Well, that'd be your old neck of the woods, wouldn't it?
Salford's in Lancashire.
Well, it's near enough.
But it got lynched for less than that. Who flagged it?
D.I. Hoskins. How are you two getting on, by the way?
Spiffingly.
Putting you through the oops, is he?
Off the record?
Mm-hmm.
I can't help feeling he's got a chip on his shoulder with my name on it.
You know why that is?
Yeah, he gets a not-so-new boy from the Met instead of being able to promote one of his own. Thinks it's a put-down for the team.
Can't do nothing about that.
Except carry on with the job. Take whatever stick comes with it.
Yeah, it'll all blow over. You need anything from me, you let me know.
Well, there is one thing.
What's that?
Get your own tea.
Out ahead.
Not always.
You could have fooled me. Well, what's the secret?
Helps if you've got a system.
A system? What does that mean?
What to look for, when to play, and when to move on. I got mine out of a book.
All right. I'm impressed. You can buy some ice cream.
Can I?
We've been here a week already. It's really boring. Can't even kick a ball on the beach with the geriatrics complaining.
Wouldn't know. I haven't seen much of the beach yet.
Too busy making money.
Don't I wish.
We saw you yesterday. Is it just you and your friend?
Yeah. Don't tell the site manager, though. He thinks there's a bunch of us.
Why?
Well, it's supposed to be a place for families, so we invented ourselves one to get us in. It was Tom's idea.
Tom's your friend? Pardon me.
Yeah, we're a team. Listen, can you keep a secret?
Don't trust her. She talks in her sleep. Don't pay any attention. What's the secret?
We're on our own in the caravan.
Is that all?
No, Actually, we're on the run. Tom and me. We're fugitives.
From prison?
No.
Bostel, then?
No. From a home.
Why did you run away?
Lots of reasons. Tom nutted someone. It was justified, though.
Well, I can imagine.
Only he's done that kind of thing before. This time they'd have locked him up.
What about you?
Me? I didn't need a reason. I couldn't stick the place, that's all. It's out of time. I've got to go. Tom will be waiting for me.
Well, thanks for the ice cream.
Anytime!
Hey, you! Did you tell your dad I'm still waiting for the rest of the rental?
You've got it!
All I've got's a deposit. There's still 70 quid outstanding. Did you tell him?
I'll tell him today.
Took you long, you know.
It's official. I'm a love machine.
Yeah, you and Nudie Mag in a paper handkerchief. How much did you get?
You know. What about you?
Half this stuff I've never heard of. The other half you haven't got.
What have you been doing then?
Improvising. Didn't have tomato paste, but tomato sauce is just the same, isn't it?
Yeah, I expect so.
You sure this will be good?
Looked great when this woman did it on this programme. Better than the slot we've been used to.
When was this?
Some afternoon thing, a couple of years ago. I wrote it all down then. Tom, you'll get a shot. We don't need this. I've made enough.
Always bite the hand that feeds you, Billy. It's good for morale.
There's nothing wrong with my morale. Come on.
Is it a recent photograph? Oh, no. Oh, one face is better than nothing at all. Look, I could really do with a copy. Just hang on a second. Is there a fax machine on the premises?
What do you think we are? Starship Enterprise?
Oh, I'm sorry I spoke, sir.
No, you keep it up. It keeps the Nick happy.
Stick it in the first-class post, will you?
One.
Stick them both in then. You think alphabet pasta will be all right in the lasagna?
I don't know. It's all the art. Spell landed not out of mine. What is your spell?
You wouldn't like to know.
Is how it looked on the programme?
What's it say the lads are headed down this way?
Well, they both bought bus tickets. As soon as they got here, they sent a postcard to one of their mates. Doesn't demand a major exercise of intellect, does it?
Any family in the area?
Neither of them. It was a low-security home, and they were both low-risk cases. No obvious reason for it at all. They lifted, what, 60 quid from the warden's petty cash and shot their head up a couple of arrows.
Nothing much to go on, then.
Except that Billy likes the Frobishers.
Oh. I've asked the remand on to send any photographs in there.
Ah, good.
And I'll run this from Abbotsbridge, if that's OK with you.
I think you're beginning to put roots down at that, Nick.
It does have a certain je ne sais quoi. I don't know what it is, though.
As soon as you're ready, sir.
What's going on here?
Oh, it's a crime prevention video. And I don't want you hanging about laughing at me, either.
Would you like a touch of powder, sir?
Bloody well would not.
You asked me. Those eggs were off. We had to go back and complain.
You reckon?
Don't see what else it could have been.
Oh, we never put the candle on the table either.
Stuff the candle.
Oh, come on, Billy. It wasn't your fault.
We'll get it right next time.
Yeah, but not today, eh, Billy?
Hi! We're having a barbecue. Do you want to come?
That smells good.
We brought some friends over. Is that all right?
Of course it is. Hello, boys.
Come and get plates.
This is great.
Well, we owed you for the ice cream. Billy said how you're both on the run.
Did he?
Well, don't worry. We won't say anything.
What else did Billy tell you?
He wouldn't tell us what his system was.
Trade secret.
Not that it's much of a secret when you can get it out of a library book.
Been working so far, though, hasn't it?
Better than your cooking.
What's it all in aid of, anyway?
We've got plans.
I know, but what?
First, we make a packet on the slot machine.
Nobody wins on those things. Not in the end.
You watch. We're going to raise some state money here. Then we'll head down into town where all the big payouts are. I've got it all worked out.
You should come with us. See how a couple of real operators work.
I think the girls are busy tonight, aren't you?
Are we?
Yes, you are.
Tomorrow night, then.
I think you'll find it the same most nights. Am I right, Julie?
Go on. Make it easy for us. What a prank.
We are going out. That much is true.
Only to avoid mixing with the riffraff, Billy. And who could that be? I wonder.
I don't want to do this.
Go on, force yourself.
He was loads to eat.
My bonnet is blue. My heart it is true. And I dare not be seen with such rubbish as you. Come on, Billy. If they leave the key, it's a shame not to use it.
Evening, Bill.
Alan, good day's crime busting.
I wouldn't know. I spent the afternoon in court.
Judy wants a word with you. You're around for a while.
I'm going nowhere. What's it about?
Oh, no. I'm not going to spoil her surprise. I'll tell her to come over. Wind your window up.
Hey.
Down and look at this. Music, eh?
Who let you in? Come on, off. Down, boy. Rabbits. Cats. What?
Through here.
Oh, I see you've met Bilston.
Bilston?
Bilston the dog, your surprise.
I don't think I like the sound of this.
Free gift, one only. Comes with the property. But didn't I tell you?
You're joking, right?
Man on his own in the country needs a dog. People think you're weird otherwise.
I hate dogs.
Oh, everybody hates Bilston. He's used to it.
What's going on, Judy?
He was my sister's dog. She got divorced and they had a fight over the custody of the dog. She lost, so she's got to keep him. She asked me to give him a home.
I don't want him.
Nobody wants Bilston. Somebody's got to have him.
Well, can't you just give him away?
Tell you what. You give him a roof over his head just for a few days, you know, till I can sort something out. And then when your chief inspector calls us up, I'll go on pretending you're living in officially approved digs with us. Instead of letting him know you're camping out in some drafty old barn.
This is blackmail.
He can't stay at the house with us. Doesn't get on with the farm dogs.
Well, who does he get on with?
Who knows? Maybe you'll be the lucky one.
Tom?
What?
Have you ever done it with a woman?
Of course I have, millions of times.
You bloody liar!
Well, when I do it, what maybe Michael McGinty? I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I didn't mean it, honest.
Nothing happened. You tried it on, but nothing did.
I know.
And it wasn't McGinty.
What? You mean I'm not in for nothing?
It was one of his friends. Someone he brought in. I don't know who.
Did the warden know?
One of the housemasters did.
You know what that makes it?
Makes it bloody impossible to stay, I know that much. I'm glad you came with me, Tom. I couldn't have made it this far on my own. I just wish you wouldn't take the piss so much, that's all.
It doesn't mean anything. It's just the way I am.
Anytime you ought to drop out, just go.
Don't talk like that. We said we'd stick together, and we will. We're on target. We're gonna be okay. Why?
'Cause we're magic.
Right, now get to sleep. I've got plans for tomorrow.
What's this? Lonely Hearts?
Go on, Mike. You must move about Doncaster's.
Ah. I see you call in to pick up your mail every now and again. What's the Abbas Bridge Nick got that we haven't?
Proximity. I can be booked on duty 10 minutes after leaving the barn. Gives me an extra half hour in bed.
Looks like you could use it.
It's the lived-in look. I hear it's coming back this year.
And what's the card for?
Ah, I was conned. Someone's given me a beast I don't want, and I'm trying to get rid of him quick.
A dog?
Well, some would call it a dog. I've got other names for it after a night of it crawling on the bed and scratching itself.
Well, you should have closed the door.
What door?
Anything else it can do?
Well, it can fart and wave it about with its tail. It's not a skill I'm much use for.
All the same, you should think about keeping it. You can take it for walks.
I can go for walks on my own, thank you very much.
I know, but it always looks strange. A man and a dog in the country, though. That's different.
It's the second time I've heard that line, and I'm not falling for it. The beast's uncontrollable.
Well, you could always try talking to somebody in the dog section about training.
I don't want to train it. I don't want to keep it.
I don't mean for keeping it. I mean for making it more appealing to somebody else.
I don't suppose you want the dog for the kids, eh?
My kids want a flattened hound and a motorbike. They're a bit past the dog stage.
Damn.
How are the new premises?
It's not bad. I've tidied up. You ought to see it compared to what it was.
All right.
Right.
Do you prefer chicken or tuna?
Anything without mayonnaise.
They didn't have mayonnaise. We'll have to have it without salad cream. What's our excuse if we get caught?
We don't need an excuse.
Rockliffe Towers. Coaches by appointment.
Why don't you stick the kettle on? I just want to check a couple of things.
Don't tidy up on my account.
Oh, no!
Brecon?
Bilston.
Here's a plan.
Can't wait.
We got nearly 50 quid out of 5 vans last night. That means we can start looking for the bigger jackpots, right?
That's how it works.
So, we don't piss around in the backwaters anymore. Get straight down into town tonight. Do all the big arcades. Make a killing.
Say there was a problem.
What sort of problem?
Say the system failed.
Well, that's not gonna happen, is it?
Say it did. What would we do then?
I'll have to phone my dad, see if he'd do us alone.
You haven't seen him in years.
He's still me dad. I'm more sticker than your average PE teacher. Anyway, that's not gonna happen, is it?
Did you move anything?
Not a thing. I've had 3 complaints already today. Vans broken into, money taken. God, will you just look at the state?
2 boys, you reckon?
2's all I've seen.
Ring any bells?
That's one of them.
How old is he?
God only knows.
So what exactly do you want me to do?
Well, just try and see if you can knock some sense into him. Give me a fighting chance of unloading him.
Why don't you just take him to the dog's home?
Well, I suppose I could do that.
Well, they'll put him on offer for a couple of weeks. Then, if nobody wants him...
Yeah. Well, just see what you can do with him, eh?
There isn't a beast on 4 legs that I can't handle.
Excuse me, Sarge.
Come on.
2 boys in a caravan down at the bay. Petty thieving at the site. I showed the photograph and got a confirmation from the site manager, same at the local amusement arcade. Parts of it had been mucked up.
Channel Islands. Should have thought of it before. They've got no family around here. One boy's father lives in Jersey.
Tax exile?
No, he's a fry cook. They must be trying to raise money to get over to him.
I see someone who knows what he's doing. I think I see someone with a system.
Just playing.
It's all right. I'm not the management or anything. I'm only making conversation.
No.
Don't be nervous. Where are you staying?
What's the matter? What is it with you and these people? You're like a magnet.
That's not funny.
Well, come on, I mean to say...
It's not funny!
All right, all right.
And I lost all our money on the bleeding machines.
Shoot.
What do you want?
Basically, I'm thoroughly ticked off. I don't want to feel better.
What's he on about?
You know, enough talking to him. Now talk to me.
I don't understand any of this. You've got the wrong person.
Last fellow tried it with my mate. I put him in hospital.
I'd better warn you. I do weight training.
Yeah? And I'm warning you. I'm a right headbanger.
I've got money. I've got a lot of cash. You can have it all.
Whatever you've got, it won't be enough.
Then you can have it. Just leave me alone.
Maybe we should give him to the pigs instead.
Take it. Please, take it. Just let me go.
Put it on the floor. Now get lost. He was actually scared of us.
I feel rotten.
Two single rooms, please. That's two single rooms, please.
Push off, Sonny.
You think we're messing about?
Of course.
I want a television in mine.
Both were televisions. Colour.
Of course. But if you're staying here, that'll have to go in the hotel safe.
Yeah, I know that. I was gonna ask.
I'll get you a receipt.
Are we magic or what?
Absolute magic. What do we do next?
First thing tomorrow morning, we get down the booking office and get ourselves places on the ferry. This time tomorrow night, we're in Jersey.
You ever been there before?
Nah.
Come on, boys, you're blocking the foyer.
We're waiting for our rooms.
And how are you thinking of paying?
Get me a thing, these bastards!
I'll walk.
Put it this way. You've learned something tonight.
Could be worse. We're dry. We've got a radio. First thing tomorrow morning, we'll get back on top of this.
Yeah.
What do you want out of life, Billy? If you could pick anything, what do you have?
I'd have a compact disc player and a full Capri. What about you?
I'd really like to meet Chuck Norris. I bet he's really interesting to talk to. My dad said he sold an hot dog to Michael Caine once, but I'm not sure I believe him.
My dad took me to a pantomime once. It was the best time I ever had.
Which one was it?
Dunno. It had a goose in it.
Was he all right then, your dad?
He was great. He was really great.
Thank you.
Rockliffe?
That's my name.
I've got just the thing for this bloody dog of yours.
Oh, what?
A shotgun. It's a public menace. Most obstinate beast that ever walked on four legs. I'm telling you, hard of him, gassed.
You're learning, Sarge.
You're learning.
Oh, Rachel?
If it's another lunch date, I've had enough of the bills and diet. Thanks very much.
It's my two juveniles. I know what they're after.
Good times and older women.
Rachel, you do us a favor. Brief the lateship to keep a lookout on the streets. They'll probably have to sleep rough tonight.
Sure.
And, Rachel, another favor. Do you know a decent hotel where I can spend a couple of nights, please?
What's he doing?
This time of night, it's obvious. He's off poaching.
How do you know?
I don't, but look at him.
Don't look the type to have money about the house.
Are you kidding? Where else would he keep it? I've heard about these country people. They never trust banks.
That's old people.
Old people and country people. I've seen it on the crime watch. Your dad?
Phone your dad, Tom. It's got to be a better way than this.
I'm handling it, Anna.
What are you doing?
Who's gonna see? Have a look in cupboards.
Where are you going?
Upstairs, have a look under the mattress.
Loaded.
The wine, yes, sir.
No, thank you. I'll just have tonic water.
How much does that leave?
70 pence.
get very far, will it?
I'll use it to call me Dad.
What's the point, Tom? I mean, look at us. We're going nowhere but down. I don't want to live like this. This is for old jocks and meth drinkers.
I'll do your deal.
What?
I'll still call him, and if it's no good, then we'll give ourselves up.
I think it's probably best.
No, that's not the deal. We'll give ourselves up, and you tell him what happened with McGinty, and his friend from outside, and which of the staff were on it, and everything.
No.
Shot the bastards, Billy.
I couldn't.
You told me.
That's different.
You're not the first underage kid to have his arse grabbed,
nothing,
you know.
Nothing happened.
I know, but something could. And whether we give ourselves up or whether we get caught, the chances are they're going to send us straight back there.
She's definitely taking samples.
I knew it. He's from the health department.
He's not one of the usual inspectors.
Maybe they're trying to catch us out. Well, they won't. All hands to the pumps, boys and girls.
What should we do?
Keep him happy. We'll get everything watertight back here. Well spotted, Bethany.
No coffee, thank you.
A liqueur, perhaps. On the house.
Oh, thank you. I'm very tired. I think I'll just go on up to bed.
Would you care to inspect the kitchen now, sir?
No, no, thank you.
Sir, are you really an inspector?
No, I'm only a sergeant. I could handle being a dog. Yeah, I could probably handle it better than this. You don't know what this is all about, do you? You don't give a stuff. That's the way to be. And we think there's something out there for us. Well, we don't know what it is, but we think we'll know it when we see it, but we don't. We never do. But you... could be for dying tomorrow, eh? That doesn't stop you being happy today, though, does it? What's the secret, eh? Oh, well. St. Cuthbert talked to a duck. Diogenes lived in a dog kennel.
About you posing as a health inspector?
What?
These people are friends of mine, Alan. How do you think it makes me look?
Rachel, I'm not in the mood. I've just paid 30 quid to spend the night in my own car.
I'll tell the management. It'll cheer them up.
Did you come all the way out here just to give me earache?
We've had developments with your runaways.
What kind of developments?
Wounding with a shotgun. Well, you said they were on the slide.
I haven't managed to stop them, though, have I?
They were turning over Joe Pinney's place when he came home and caught them.
I know that name.
Suspected poacher, never convicted.
I pulled his fire, took it home. Whitmore said he was too clever to be caught.
Oh, too clever for his own good. He nearly bled to death from a shoulder wound because he was determined to crawl around getting rid of anything we could pin on him before he'd call for help. He'll live. We'll be playing no table tennis for a while.
I'll talk to him.
Borrow a comb first.
Directory inquiries. Which town, please?
It's a Jersey number.
Thank you.
Sierra Whiskey 4328, on my way.
Don't come on.
Hello?
Hello, Dad. It's me. It's Tom. I bet you're surprised.
I've been expecting this.
Really?
The police were in touch. What the hell do you think you're doing?
I know. It's all been going wrong.
You can't come here. You know that. Even if I had room, they'd just pick you up on ferry.
I was wondering if you could lend us for the fair. If we both travel separately, I reckon we could get away with it.
Who is it?
Just a minute. It's all right.
It's nobody. What was that last man?
Nothing. Luke, I'll have to go, Dad. The money's running out.
Yeah. Look, get this cleared up, and then someday we'll have to get together.
Same old Dad.
Bloody end.
Come on then, let's get it over with.
Window.
Come with me. Bring the dog.
Come with.
Don't you want a statement?
Later.
What's the law about pufters who can't keep their hands off young lads?
Pufters aren't interested in boys. What you're talking about are paedophiles.
What's the difference?
All the difference in the world.
Mania. Hooray! We greet you now, Your Majesty, your loyal subjects true. We offer heartfelt loyalty, your bidding fly to do. And if you should upon us call, command us do or die, we'll rally round you.
Billy.
How I wish I might go with them.
It is better not. You have no wings, and they will fly very swiftly and silently over the mountain tops.
Just trust me.
There's no going back, is there?
No, Billy. There never is. Come on.
Get in.
Good, isn't it?
Yeah, fantastic.
Just think. I was the one who wanted to jack it in. And I was the one who ran.
You all right?
Right. We're going to wait here for a van. Nobody do anything silly. All right?
There's something I want to tell you.
I'm listening.
Ian Hogg, alias Detective Sergeant Rockliffe, will be a guest in the open air studio tomorrow morning. If you have any questions or comments for him, the phone lines are open now.